Hola YouTube, my name is Ricardo Lino and I'm a wheel addict. Have you ever heard that bending your knees is the most important thing when you're starting to skate? Well, not really. Let me explain you why. It's a very common mistake of people to think that once they put their skates on, if they bend their knees, they are going to start skating instantaneously, but that's not really like that. There's in fact something else that you can do with your body to make you feel more stable on your skates, which is not bending your knees. But before we go ahead and I start telling you why bending the knees is not the most important thing, let me just tell you that this video is sponsored by Skillshare. And if you didn't know what Skillshare is, well, Skillshare is an online learning platform where you can basically learn everything. In fact, you can even learn how to skate. If you're one of the first 1,000 people to use the link in the description of this video, you will have access to a 30 days trial of Skillshare premium membership, and that will give you access to my How to Skate Beginners course, which is right now available on Skillshare. So don't miss this opportunity and click the link. Thank you, Skillshare, for sponsoring this video. Let me just tell you why bending your knees is not the most important. You know, your body is going to work just like this elastic that I have right here. When you extend, the whole thing should extend. When you flex, the full thing should flex. Let me show you that on skates. So here's the thing. Bending your knees, it's not exactly wrong. The biggest problem is that most people, they bend their knees and they feel like they are doing a squat in the gym. So they're bending their knees and they're like here. So they feel like they're falling backwards all the time. There's a way to actually avoid that, and that is by doing dorsiflexion. And you might be thinking, what is a dorsiflexion? Well, that's the type of movement that you can do with your ankle when you pull your toes up. This is dorsiflexion. This is plantar flexion. Dorsiflexion, plantar flexion. It's actually very easy. But the thing is, you're not going to be skating pulling your toes up. What you're going to be doing while you're cruising, or the basic position, it's going to be in fact the opposite way. Think that instead of pulling your toes up, you're going to do the exact same movement, but what you bring forward is your shins. So it's basically the same. Plantar flexion, dorsiflexion. Now, the dorsiflexion doesn't need to be done with your knees bent. You can also do it by leaning forward. Basically, what I want you to understand is how important it is, in my opinion, the most important thing in order to be able to be stable on skates, to feel a little bit of pressure against the front of your skate. You see this part here? You want to make pressure with your shins against it. Now, in order for you to do it, if you bend your knees, that's correct. But just like the elastic, remember when I told you the elastic, if I pull it, the whole thing extend. If I flex it, the whole thing flex. Same thing. If I'm going to flex my ankle and my knees, I also need to flex my hips. So I need to bring my bum back there and lean my upper body forward. So this would be a more correct position. The biggest problem that I see when someone says that it's very important to bend their knees is that they bend their knees but they leave their bum right there. You cannot do that. If you bend your knees, you need to also bring your shins forward and lean your upper body forward. So I would say the most important thing is actually the dorsiflexion. And one way for you to understand if you're doing it right would be if you look from the top. If you see too much of your skates, well, that means that you are too much on your heels. So what can you do? Well, bring your feet under your body. Feel the front, feel the shin against the front of the skate. Now, this is a more correct position. That is basically it. Another way for you to feel a little bit more stable would be bringing your head forward a bit. I know that most of the people watching this would be scared to fall forward, but let me just tell you one thing. Your whole life, you've been able, or I'm pretty sure you've commonly tripped on something and you just fell forward. Now, falling backwards is a completely new thing. How many times did you stepped on a banana? It's very rare, so you don't know actually how to fall, and that's why it's so much more dangerous. So all you need to do is to feel the front of your skate with your shins. That's basically it. Now, bending your knees is important, but always remember, when you bend your knees, also bring your hips back there and lean your upper body forward. Always feeling the shins against the front of the skate. Most important tip that I gave you today. And that is it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you learned something today. If you did learn something, do not forget to subscribe to this channel. If you're a beginner, and if there's something that you would like me to teach you, well, let me know in the comments. I'm more than happy to make one of these tutorials and try to bring you guys from here to here if possible. Now, with that being said, if you enjoyed this video, do not forget to give me a thumbs up. If you didn't like it, you can give me a thumbs down. And if you want to support this channel, you can always become a member or you can become a patron. Very easy. More important than anything else is to never ever, like ever ever, forget why we all started skating, and that is because it's fun. Now, cheers and see you soon. Someone